हैप्पी मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. माय नेम इज मिस्टर खड़ांगड़े पंकज. हियर वी आर लर्निंग चैप्टर नंबर 5, इवोल्यूशन ऑफ मैनकाइंड. इन दिस स्टडी वी हैव लर्न 5.1 फ्रॉम होमो हैबिलिस टू होमो सेपियंस सेपियंस. इन दिस सब पॉइंट वॉज देयर द स्किल्ड ह्यूमन. द स्किल्ड ह्यूमन, स्किल्ड ह्यूमन मीन्स the species of humans who could use their hands skillfully is known as the skilled human. So like this definition we have learned, and you are right, you have written it in your notebook also. Then what is mean by homo habilis? In Latin language, homo means man and habilis means the one who use his hands skillfully. The one who use his hands skillfully is called habilis. Okay, so like this we have learned in the skilled human. Now we are going to learn Homo erectus. Our next point is Homo erectus. Homo erectus. Homo erectus. See, open your textbook, page number 19. See, Homo erectus mark an important stage in human evolution. Erectus means the one who stands erect. Hence, the name Homo erectus. Compared to Homo habilis, he had a more developed brain. Humans of the Homo erectus species live in groups. See now what is given here, Homo erectus. In this, Homo erectus mark an important stage in human evolution. This one is important stage in human evolution. Erectus means the one who stands erect. See, we have seen that in first, that skilled human, his spine was slightly bent like this. But here Homo erectus means that you can stand straight, erect, like this. Okay? Hence, the name Homo erectus. Compared to Homo habilis, compared to our Homo habilis, he had a more developed brain. Humans of the Homo erectus species live in groups. And these Homo erectus species lives in groups. Understood? Next, having seen wildfires, humans knew about fire. It is likely that Homo erectus had learned the technique of fetching the burning branches of tree to use that fire. During his time, most of the earth was covered with ice sheet. Therefore, the climate was extremely cold. Homo erectus could survive in that extremely cold climate because he had learned to use fire. However, he had not yet mastered the technique of making fire. This much we'll see. See, having seen wildfires. What you have seen? Wildfires. Human knew about fire. In forest, they saw wildfires. Human knew about the fire. It is likely that Homo erectus had learned the technique of fetching the burning branches of trees to use that fire. But they were taking those branches. They were taking burning branches, they were taking for the fire.
During his time, most of the earth was covered with ice. During this Homo erectus time, that time most of the part of our earth was covered with ice. Therefore, turn your page. Therefore, the climate was extremely cold. Homo erectus could survive in that extremely cold climate. See, Homo erectus could survive in that extremely cold climate because he had learned to use fire. However, he had not yet mastered the technique of making fire. Here, he had not learned the technique of making fire, but he was using the fire. Tools made by the Homo erectus were more developed and symmetrical compared to those made by Homo habilis. You can see on the screen. Tools made by the Homo erectus were more developed. Those were more developed and symmetrical compared. You have learned in math symmetrical, geometrical. Okay. Symmetrical means, suppose circle part is there. So half this symmetrical part is this one. Okay. Like this. Now, compared to those made by Homo habilis, Homo erectus made tools like the hand axe. How they made tools like hand axe? Remains of Homo erectus have been found along with these, with his tools in the continent of Africa. And we found it in the continent of Africa along with his tools of Africa, Asia and Europe. Where it found? In Africa, Asia and Europe. Okay, you understand? Okay, so thanks for watching this video. Tomorrow again we will meet with the same chapter.